Hello students, Vivek Sundarwa here from Sri Brahman Institute of Teachers Education, Chapad. Let's start with a subject in BBA Semester 5, Business Law. And that first unit is Introduction to Law and Legal System. First of all, as we all know that man is a social animal. As we are living in the society, we will have to follow the rules and regulations of society. As a human being or as a people of India, it is our primary obligation to follow the rules and regulations. Everyone wants to live in a civilized society or polished society. Everyone wants to live their life with the best. It is possible with the help of law. Law means it is one kind of fixations of rules, regulations or guidelines. Why law is required? As we know that law is quite essential. Why? Suppose if you are driving a car, if you are riding a bike, but if someone is driving car rudely, then what will happen? Or if someone is not following the traffic rules, then what will happen? These rules will have to be followed by the people of our country. Why? All because of law. We are safe. Why? Because of law. Say for example, as we are facing the problems of pandemic COVID-19, there is a rule, there is a regulation that you must maintain social distance or you must wear a mask. If you will not do that, then you will be penalized. So first of all, in unit first, introduction to law and legal system. And then introduction to law. The word law has been derived from the Teutonic word lag, which means definite. Law gives surety. Surety about you must follow the rules. You strictly follow the guidelines of government. Definite means it is based on particular system. It is based on particular regulation. Law can be defined as rule of conduct in human relations. Conduct means behavior. Suppose a person is not behaving well in the society, then you will call him a lunatic or a people with unsound mind. The person who is not behaving properly with the other people or trying to damage the other people, then law will save from that people. Human relation. To maintain the human relation, it is quite important to live in the limitation of the law. Human relation means to treat fairly with each and everyone. You are not going to make bias with anyone. After that, it also means a uniform rule of conduct which is applicable equally to all the people of the state. Law means equality, justice. Every people of the country should be treated equally. We cannot make bias or prejudice with anyone. After that, it has been called Dharma in Hindu religion and Hukam in Islamic jurisprudence. As far as Hindu religion is concerned, law is called dharma. Dharma means a proper guideline, a proper way how to lead the society, how to live in the society. Or in the Islamic jurisprudence, it is called hukum. Hukum means it is one kind of strict rule, or it is one kind of guideline that all the people must follow that guideline. It is hukum. The mandatory rules of conduct were intended to enforce justice and prescribe duty or obligation. As far as law is concerned, there are two things. Law is for to make society an idealistic society or practical society. In our Indian constitution, there are two things. That first is fundamental duty, second is fundamental right. What is fundamental duty? It is our obligation that you should perform this. What is right? Right means no one can deny what is yours will be yours always. After that, the sovereign power of parliament to promulgate. The person who is successor, the person who is promulgator, who is promulgating the law, by whom it is promulgated, it is promulgator. Law is enforced or promulgated by parliament. After that, commercial law or enforced by the imposition of penalties. There are certain people who are not following the guidelines of law. What to do with them? Simple thing is that penalty is there. Say for example, your bill of electricity is due. If you are not paying your taxes or bill on the time, then you will be penalized. You will have to give the penalties. So penalty is necessary. Why? Because certain people are not following the guidelines or rules, then you will have to lesson them. You will have to give them lesson that you must follow this guideline. So that's why penalty is given. Commercial law or mercantile law is the law that regulates the commercial activities of the economy. So far as the business law is concerned, it is all about commercial law or mercantile law. What is business law or commercial law? It is all about the transactions. Transaction means it is dealing, one kind of dealing. You are making contract, or one person is making contract with the other person. It is called a transaction. Contract is possible when there is a transaction. Without transaction, there is no contract. So first and foremost in mercantile law is transaction or contract. So in business law, we will discuss about the different objects of the law or what are the requirements to form a contract. After that, what is the definition of law? Law means a body of fixed rules. In each and every, whether it is a district, a taluka, or state, country, whatever, then there will be fixed rules. Fixed rule means you cannot go above the law. You must maintain the rules and regulations. Sovereign political authority. Another thing is that enforced by a sovereign political authority. Law is enforced by political party, political people. The party who is ruling will decide according to Jomosity. A system of rules. A union of primary and secondary rules. Hard. Law means in that primary and secondary rules are given. So it is quite essential to have the knowledge of law. You cannot escape yourself by saying that I don't know about the law. Say for example, if you are driving a car or if you are passing from a road, if you are not following the traffic rules, then you cannot say, I don't know how to drive my car or I don't know about the signals. You cannot do that. Why? Because it is compulsory to follow the rules and regulation. So in simple sense, law means it is one kind of fixed framework. In that limitation, you will have to work. As we know that India is a democratic country. India is a democratic nation. So we have right. We can freely express our ideas. So, as far as the law is concerned, it is quite essential to have the practical knowledge of law. So, in my next lecture, we will discuss about the objects of the law or what are the different things which are included in law. Thank you.